Come to Mick and Ralph's for all your shopping needs. We've got stuff we're not even allowed to sell.
You look new to Freeside, so here's a little advice, friend. Don't go past the Southgate greeter without talking to it first. Those bots are programmed to vaporize anyone who enters the fenced-in area without authorization from the greeter. The name's Old Ben. I've been living in Freeside since the day I was born. I've done a bit of everything around here. Courier, butcher, crier, escort, gun for hire. Some of which I'm not proud of, but I do my best to help around town when needed. Exactly one of the reasons I got out of that job. Too many shifty characters looking to have someone else move their hot items. My father ran a butcher shop here in town. But business went downhill when another vendor started selling this strange meat at half our prices. You're telling me, not long after my father's shop went under and he passed away from the loss, people around town started experiencing shakes. No one gets shakes like that unless they're eating human flesh. But no one would believe me. The sick bastard gradually went insane and passed away. Wasn't long before someone moved into the guy's place and found half-buried human remains in the crawl space. I didn't bother saying, "Told you so." After a while, I made enough money to get a passport into Vegas. Back then, you could get approved for entry for a fraction of what it costs now. Well, I got a job working as a crier outside of the Tops, advertising for the local talent performing at the casino. That didn't last long. Well, being a suave young guy, I chatted up the ladies from time to time, and one of the manager's girls started to take a liking to me. I never touched the woman, but the jealous prick decided it was my time to go. He framed me by saying I'd stolen from the casino. Sure enough, a few grand was missing from the casino vault. I have to assume the bastard stole the funds and figured I was a convenient fall guy. Yeah, but what can you do? I was stripped of my casino apartment and all of my belongings and booted back into Freeside. From there, I didn't have a lot of career options, as my rep was destroyed. So the escort job sort of fell into my lap. No pun intended. Well, I suppose you could look at it that way, but I was packing a whole different kind of heat. No, escort just sounds better than man-whore. Yep. I was damn good at my job, too. But after a while, I just felt like a piece of meat and had to quit. When I quit the escort job, I had enough money to buy a pistol belt and some other gear. Bodyguards make a good, honest living, and I had the wits and physical build to handle most thugs. After saving a few tourists from trouble, I got a reputation for being a stand-up guy again, and after a decade, managed to save up enough to retire. All right. See ya.
You have entered. Submit to a credit check, or present your passport before proceeding to the gate. Trespassers will be shot. Admission to the strip requires an official passport or proof that you are carrying the required minimum balance. These policies prevent less reputable persons from entering and ensure a good time will be had by all who enter the strip. I'm sorry, but your balance does not meet the minimum balance. If you are unable to meet the minimum balance requirement, an official passport is an acceptable alternative. Please return when you have sufficient cash or passport.
Hello again. Yep.
Those squatters think they're entitled in. I used to guard at the gate, but there's no money in it these days.
The squatters have been more and more trouble.
It's never dull in Freeside, is it? The squatters have been more and more trouble lately.
It's never dull in Freeside, is it?
What do we have here? Another petitioner for the king? Who's the king? You believe this asshole man? In Freeside, the kings rule. and the king rules the kings. Got it? Anything's possible, I suppose. How much is it worth to you to meet the big man? Then the king has no interest in seeing you.
Hi. What's up?
Space meaning anything to you?
You're not a king. Does the king know you're up here?
Hi.
Do I know you? Whatever.
Look who's back. If you want to see the king, you better pay up. What, do I look like a beggar to you? Take a hike, cheapskate.
Hi.
Lasers, plasma, pistols, grenade. You want to get your hands on some of the deadliest weapons around? Head just down the street to the Silver Rush. You won't be disappointed.
Yeah.
Good day.
Welcome to the Atomic Wrangler. What can I get you? We've got liquor, chems, and whores aplenty. Pick your fix, and we'll oblige. Our only rule is no sampling the merchandise. Caps paid in advance. If you'd like to do a bit of gambling, we have an exchange at the back of the casino on the left. I have some work I need handled. Back before we instituted the caps up front rule, we used to allow customers tabs. Well, needless to say, a few customers snuck out without paying their bills. We need someone to collect. The job would pay a percentage. If you bring all their debts back, we'll give you a cut of each. 25% is more than fair. It would add up to 150 caps if you bring them all in. All right, 50-50 it is, but you better bring back all of the caps. If we hear you crossed us, the next bounty hunter will be coming for you. Great. There are three people who need to be tracked down. A real mixed basket of fruits. Their names are Grex, Santiago, and Lady Jane. Grex is a bit cracked, but mostly harmless. Just don't mention anything about his lazy eye. He owes 138 caps and should still be around Freeside. Lady Jane fancies herself a high roller, but she's just another dirtbag NCR prospector. I'm not sure where to find her. I hear she's run goods for the followers of the Apocalypse in the past, but other locals might know more. She owes us 250 caps. Santiago is a suave son of a bitch, but a total pansy when it comes to fisticuffs. He owes 212 caps and should be around Freeside as well. Anything else you need? Yep.
Spare a few caps. That all depends on who's asking. Ah, crap. I was hoping they'd forget about my tab. Look, I've got the caps right here. Just don't hurt me. For not killing me.
How are you today?
Santiago is fabulous. Santiago does not owe anyone. Santiago is a Freeside VIP. Indeed, Santiago is a poet among pretenders. If you're here to collect for the Garretts, Santiago is debt-free. Sir, Santiago told you. Santiago has no debts. Ow! Okay, here. Take the caps. Just don't hurt Santiago again. Bye.
If it can be bought, it can be found at Mick and Ralph's.
Hello. Lovely to meet you. In that case, I suppose you're here to collect. I apologize, but I simply do not have enough caps on me to cover the debt. If someone were to recover my caravan from that cave, I could easily pay in full. But who would bother with such a mess? But what about those nasty critters? Very well. But please do be careful. I will be returning to California to start anew. If anything is left of the caravan, please keep it as a show of thanks for your kindness. It is so rare to meet good, friendly people in the wastes. Here is the last location of the caravan. Good luck.
People only at Mick and Ralph's.
The Kaisar has marked you for death, and the Legion obeys. Ready yourself for battle.
Yeah.
Stay out of the control room and enclosure, or there's gonna be trouble. Got it?
Thank you. trooper ready to fight.
Like that?